Hi there, it's me, Teacher Mike from Phuket Pals. Welcome back to another video. In this one, I'm going to teach you how to write a simple, fast and effective introduction for the four essay types in IELTS Writing Task 2. Now, if you can't remember what those four different essay types are, you can go back and check out the videos earlier in the course. If you haven't, don't worry, you can watch on in this video where I go through the four types again. So the number one rule of introductions for IELTS Writing Task 2 is keep it simple. Okay, keep it simple, guys. Two or three sentences is enough. Don't fall into the trap of writing way, way, way too much for the introduction. It's not necessary. You don't have the word count and you don't have the time. So keep it to two or three sentences. This means you have more word count and more time to develop those body paragraphs and expand your ideas, which, as we know already, this is what gets you the higher points and will get you over a band 7.5 in the test itself. Okay, so I want to teach you two different introductions, a two sentence introduction, as you can see, and a three sentence introduction. Now, there's no rule for writing task two about whether it should be two sentences or three sentences. I just teach students both of these because I know myself when I come to write model answers for task two, that sometimes a two sentence intro feels right and sometimes a three sentence intro feels right. So it just depends on the type of question you're being asked and just, you know, how your flow, your thinking process is at that point in time. So I would learn and practice both of these so that when you go into the exam on exam day, you'll just be able to blast out one or the other. Okay, so the two sentence intro, the first sentence, you paraphrase the question statement. Okay, so you write the question statement again in your own words. Then sentence two, you directly answer the question. Okay, now this paraphrasing the question part, this can take some practice. I highly recommend that at home and in your practice, you need to sit down and, you know, get 5 to 10 essay task two questions in front of you and just practice paraphrasing the question statement. You know, practice writing it in your own words. It does take a bit of practice, but it will, with time, it will become easier. Now, the three sentence intro, what you do is sentence one, generally talk about the essay topic. So you can identify the main topic of the essay from the question statement. So it might, the essay topic might be about children using mobile phones, or it could be about fast food in today's society, or the influence of American culture and around the world, or whatever. So the first sentence, you'll kind of generally talk about that. You won't give specific information. All you're doing is whetting the appetite of the reader, hooking the reader, and making them interested in what is to come in the essay. Sentence two, you'll focus the first idea a little more. So you'll give a little bit more detail on your first sentence, a little bit more specific. Okay, so if you imagine this paragraph being like looking through a camera when you're taking a photograph, sentence one will be zoomed out as far as you can zoom out. Okay, it's very general. The next sentence, you zoom in quite a bit more. You give more specific details. You can see more. You're giving the reader more. Okay, more details, more specifics. Then the last sentence, you directly answer the question. Okay, and that with this, you would zoom right in. You're being very specific here and telling the reader exactly what you're going to prove in the essay or discuss in the essay. So what we'll do is we will look at a two sentence intro and a three sentence intro for the four different essay types. We'll start with the first essay type, which is opinion. Let's have a look at the question. It says, it is inevitable that as technology advances, traditional cultures will be lost. It seems that we cannot have these two things together. To what extent do you agree or disagree? Now, as I keep mentioning in my videos, this phrase, to what extent, to what extent, don't let this freak you out on exam day, okay? It just means by how much do you agree or disagree? This is a very common question type. When you get it, my advice to you is to agree 100% or disagree 100%. You can go down the middle, but it's dangerous because you might end up writing a discussion essay and not giving your opinion. And you would lose your task response points if you did that. So choose a side of the argument, agree or disagree, and then support it 100% accordingly. Okay, so let's look at the two sentence intro. Remember, for this one, we are paraphrasing the question statement and then, you know, directly answering the question. Developments in technology are seen by many as contributing to the erosion of traditional culture. In my opinion, technological advances and traditional culture can flourish side by side if both government and individuals take action in recognizing the importance of both. Okay, so you can see this answers pretty much everything here. We paraphrase everything effectively and we state a very clear opinion. And we even say, you know, that government and individuals need to take action. So we'll talk about government in body paragraph one and individuals in body paragraph two. So it's a nice example there. Moving on. This is the same question, okay, the same opinion question. But here's the three sentence intro for it. Remember, the first sentence is a general sentence about the essay topic. The next sentence gives more detail about that sentence, and the third sentence states the position, our position, or it directly answers the question. Here it is. Technology is developing at a lightning fast pace in the modern era. This has resulted in aspects of traditional culture dying out in countries around the world. I agree with the question, as this is a natural process and should be welcomed as cultural progress. Okay, so again, you get three sentences working there instead of two. And again, as I said, it's up to you whether you use a two sentence or a three sentence intro. I would practice both of them at home, as sometimes some essay questions, it just feels more natural sometimes to write three sentences instead of two. It just depends on the wording of the question that you get. Okay, so practice both. Moving on. That's moving on to the discussion essay. So this is essay number two. Introduction for a discussion essay. Here's the question. Some people believe the aim of university education is to help graduates get better jobs. Others believe there are much wider benefits of university education for both individuals and society. Discuss both views. Okay, so we have a straightforward discussion essay here. We don't have to give our opinion on this, but we have to discuss both sides. Let's look at the two sentence intro. There are many who believe students should attend university to boost their employability, while others feel that the academic and social lessons learned in third level education have wider implications for the student and society. This essay will explore both possibilities. Okay, notice I didn't give my opinion here at all. And this quite long first sentence clearly paraphrases everything that's going on here. Okay, it's a big paraphrase. There's lots of good vocab in there as well. Boost their employability, that's quite nice. Academic and social lessons learned. Okay, third level education, another way to say university education, have wider implications. Okay, just wider implications means like wider effects or wider impacts. Okay, so yeah, that's a two sentence intro for that. Here's the three sentence intro. Again, same question. The purpose of a university education has become a subject of debate. Some think the point of tertiary education is to increase a person's viability in the job market, while others believe the benefits for students and society go beyond employability. These ideas will be discussed in this essay. Sorry, that should be these, not this. These ideas will be discussed in this essay. Okay, so sentence one is very, very general. Okay, the purpose of a university education has become a subject of debate. Very general. We zoom in on the next sentence and give more specific detail from the question. Some think the point of a tertiary education, that's another way to say a university education, is to increase a person's viability in the job market. That means how viable they are in the job market, how useful or, you know, their viability in the job market means like how employable they are or how useful they will be. While others believe the benefits for students and society go beyond employability. Okay, so there are more benefits for individuals and society in general than just people getting jobs as a result of university education. These, apologies for the spelling mistake, these ideas will be discussed in this essay. Okay, so that's the discussion essay. Moving on to advantages and disadvantages essay. Let's have a look at the question. In order to solve traffic problems, governments should tax private car owners heavily and use the money to improve public transportation. What are the advantages and disadvantages of such a solution? Okay, so two sentence intro. In modern times, traffic congestion has become one of the most serious problems facing urban areas, prompting many to call for the government to tax car owners and improve public transportation. The advantages and disadvantages of this will be discussed in this essay. As you can see again, first sentence is a clear paraphrase of the question's statement here. And then we have just a little sentence saying what we're going to do. Okay, the advantages and disadvantages of this will be discussed in this essay. Okay, so same question again. Three sentence intro. Over the past century, traffic congestion has got rapidly worse in major urban centres around the world. This has prompted some to call for government to take action and tax private car owners, thus using the revenue to improve public transport systems. The advantages and disadvantages of this issue will be discussed in this essay. Again, so we've got a first sentence gives the reader a general idea about the essay topic. Okay, and then the second one gives more information, more specific information from the question. And the last sentence just tells the reader, or the examiner, if you will, what we're going to do. And then the last one is the dreaded two-part question. Oh my goodness, if I had $10 for every student who's come up to me over the years and panicking about the two-part question, there's nothing to panic about, okay? Take it easy. I will take you through everything. Don't worry. Here's how to do the intro. Developed countries have created many environmental problems in the world, particularly in their contribution to global warming. Why is global warming a problem? What can be done to reduce the dangers of global warming? So you can see two questions here related to a problem, which is global warming. And in particular, it's global warming caused by developed countries. Be careful with a question like this. It's not really asking you about the developing world's contribution to global warming. So there's not really any point talking about it, okay? You will get your task response questions if you stick to developed countries. As I said, keep it simple. Don't overcomplicate. This is not a university essay, okay? This is an IELTS essay. So just stick to the task response. Do what they ask you and nothing more. Here's the two-sentence intro. There is no doubt that industrialized nations have and continue to negatively impact on environmental issues, particularly global warming. This essay will discuss the reasons why global warming is such a pressing issue and what individuals and governments can do to mitigate the problem. Okay, again, we have paraphrased here and we've said in the second sentence what we're going to do. Okay, notice here, industrialized nations. It's a good synonym, a good collocation and synonym to use for developed countries. We have here some nice collocations here. Negatively impact. I advise students to use that a lot in IELTS writing. Negatively impact, positively impact, environmental issues. Okay. This essay will discuss the reasons why global warming is such a pressing issue, which is question one, and what individuals and governments can do to mitigate the problem, which is question two, okay? It's as simple as that. In your second sentence, just say what you're going to, you just answer the, you say what you're going to do. It's simple as that. Say what you're going to do. The essay will discuss question one, the reasons why global warming is such a pressing issue, and question two, what individuals and governments can do to mitigate or reduce, try to reduce. Mitigate means to try to reduce something. Often the word mitigate is used with problems. Very useful for IELTS writing task two. Mitigate the problem. What can the government do to mitigate the issues? Okay, what can the individual do to mitigate the problem of global warming? Mitigate the problem of traffic congestion, mitigate the problem of smoking among young people, whatever, drug use, anything. Okay, so here's the three sentence intro for a two-part question. Since the advent of the Industrial Revolution, developed nations have been polluting the Earth's atmosphere with dangerous chemicals. This has resulted in global warming, should be an in there. This essay will discuss why this is such a serious problem and also offer some ways to mitigate the threat global warming has for planet Earth and the survival of all its living things. Okay, so let's look at that again. Since the advent, that means the beginning. Advent is a useful word for IELTS writing task two. It just means the beginning. Since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, developed nations have been polluting the Earth's atmosphere with dangerous chemicals. So a general first sentence. Give more detail. This has resulted in global warming. Okay, so we're focused now on what the question is about, and we're going to be hitting our task response points here. What are we going to do? This essay will discuss why this is such a serious problem and also offer some ways to mitigate the threat global warming has for planet Earth and the survival of all its living things. Okay, so that's, you can see there. The last sentence again, answer, talks about how what we will do with both questions. You can see that clearly. Moving on. Okay, so that's about it. That's the four essay types, and I hope that provided you with answered a few questions for you. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comments. But really, if you practice answering essay questions with, you know, kind of two sentence and three sentence introductions, you will improve your speed and you will keep to that important word count. So thank you for your time, and I'll see you for the next video. Thanks.